My
pleasure. We are live and reaching you from Lagos, Nigeria, the heart of Africa.
Thanks.
Yes, Lagos is where it all happens, you know. Yes, we're waiting for you. We're going to do a test, but let me check the time. We might as well just go on. There is no point testing and then losing. Yeah, it's 10 minutes to 7. Those who were rushing to join us at 7, I'm sure they will catch up with us eventually. So, yeah, your camera is well positioned. I think I am also well positioned now. So, we're sweating trying to reach you. So let me just make sure that my face, it's not easy to reach a big man, you know.
who is a big man?
Oh, you are the big man. You are the big man. No, so, okay, we are going to have an interesting chat today. Could you just say hello to our viewers and just a quick introduction?
Hello, Nigerians. My name is Chibike Rotimi Amechi. I currently work as the Minister for Transportation.
Thank you. So we have our usual protocol. Before we start, we will play you some music because we try to make this as entertaining as possible. You are not on trial. We are here to celebrate a great son of Africa, and I will be doing my introduction after the music. So we're supposed to start at 7, but we might as well just start now. And the music is ready. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
I thought the music was ready. Okay.
Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe. Oh, yes, I believe. In the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Oh yes, I believe.
Mighty Father, I believe.
In you believe. Oh yes, I believe. Oh yes, I believe.
Jesus Christ, do you believe?
Oh, yes, I believe. Oh, yes, I believe. Oh, yes, I believe. In the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. In the Father and the Son. Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe. I think you stop this music. You're making me cry. Without stopping, you're making me cry. Dele, I think you stop this music. You're making me to cry. Oh, yes, I believe. And the Holy Spirit.
That is our protocol here. We know
I asked you to stop it because you are making me to cry.
Oh, wow. Why?
Wow. It takes me back to the history of my political career and the role God had played in my life. So,
wow. I'm sorry about that.
No, but it's okay. Well, I'm back to normal.
we to make a whole Amechi cry. That cannot be Amechi's job. Oh, wow. You're actually emotional.
I am. Why? I'm not even. If you recall what you've passed through, the role God has been playing in your life, if you recall the challenges, the betrayals, the fact that God has consistently remained with you for nearly how many years? I've been in politics from 1987 till now, and I've never left public office. You can do nothing but believe in Christ.
Wow. Before I continue, I want to confirm that people are seeing us on Instagram, on Facebook, and Twitter all over the world. And YouTube, we're doing all four for this great man tonight. We want the whole world to see him and celebrate his achievements with us. Can people confirm to me? Fantastic. I can see the signs. My brother, please calm down. Don't worry. I've never seen you in this mood. But
you may still cry more today. Nothing will make me cry other than God. Nothing.
Oh.
Absolutely nothing will make you cry.
Fantastic. It's just that,
you know, when you look back at what God has done for you, when you look back at the challenges you met on earth, when you look back at the fact that some people want you down, want to bring you down, and God has always been in front, waging the war for you, you want to wonder what else you can do but to tell God how much you love him and how much you want to worship him. So that song was quite a song that prepared my political career growing up politically. And especially when I left the country to Ghana. When I left the country to Ghana and I spent nearly 10 months in Ghana. And then becoming the time I had the disagreement with the former president. And then that you have assisted in your life betraying you. And in all of this, God has always stayed firm. But again, I don't want to discuss politics. Can we discuss my ministry?
Well, we want you to inspire a lot of the young people who are home now watching you. But before we do that, I must do a proper introduction. It is only proper that I do an introduction. I want the whole world to know that you have always been very special to me. Every man has a right to choose his friends. I disagree with you all the time on politics, but I love you absolutely in terms of your brains, your hard work, your tenacity. So, and it's always been the same with you. I remember one night you told me when the former American Consul General, you were having a party. I am sure the memories are coming back to you. And you said your wife knows that there are some people, there are a few of your friends who will take bullets for you, and that you consider me one of them. And I was so touched. I think something is freezing. I don't know where that is coming from. I hope you can hear me, sir. Can you hear me? Please bear with us. We'll be back in a second. It was freezing and I was just about making some serious declarations. Has anyone noticed His Excellency online?
yet I can see Apostle Locadia all the way from South Africa. Good evening, woman of God. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you. I hope very soon. Okay, I can see Oga now. I hope very soon you'll be able.
Oh, thank God. Okay.
Sorry, yeah. Somebody just from nowhere called my phone.
Oh,
and that happens regularly. I can't have a conversation because people are just interfering.
Okay. Maybe what happens if that happens again, you may have to put on the do not disturb on your notification on the phone. Yes, if you go into your phone, but let's carry on. But if it happens again, all you have to do is put on the do not disturb. So I was going to say that every man has a right to choose his friend. And everyone who knows me knows that once I say you are my friend, I will not wait till you die before I begin to write a geography. That is what we see in most parts of Africa. People wait for you and then they start praising you. I'll praise you when you are alive. I will praise you whatever happens. So tonight, I have the pleasure of introducing my very dear friend, my very dear brother, Chibuke Rotimi Amuchi. And the viewership, you can't believe it, is so huge. And it's from everywhere in the world. So people are already sending messages in. So I want to start by talking about the very beginning, because just now you were saying when you remember. So I want people to know where you schooled. A lot of these young people don't read history these days. They just hear Amechi and probably think you just got here one day. So can you give us that trajectory?
Okay, but let me start by saying to you, Dele, how important you are to me too as a friend. Don't forget what I told you. I think it was your 50th. As a governor, Senator Fikoye met at the airport, and we both agreed that don't go to Dele's 50th birthday and see trouble. That would say you will know that it will determine your friendship. I think it was your 50th. Was it your 50th?
It was my 50th, yes, was in London, yes.
Yeah. London. Because it was separate from this birthday I had for you at the hotel in Eko
Hotel. The Radisson. No, it was the Radisson in Lagos.
It was Radisson that I invited your
the
wife
one that you conspired with my wife and made me look. I never believed anybody could surprise me.
That day you cried. Don't forget.
I cried. That day
you cried. But I just want to say how much I cherish the friendship. And they are not, it's not too easy to come by friends. People in public office are usually used as a stool, as a stepping stone to achieving their objective. Once people achieve their objective, they abandon that friendship. So I don't play with your friendship. And the gentleman you talked about, the former consul general of the American embassy. And I want to say what he told me one day that nearly made me cry too. He looked at me, we had a dinner with the former chairman of APC, with the former governorship candidate of Lagos and some others in his house. He invited us for a dinner. At the end of the dinner, he was seeing us off and his wife walked in. And he told his wife that, listen, there are two very close people in my life. The two closest persons in my life are not friends. Honestly, I never thought he was talking about me. So I talked to him and I said, who? I thought he would say his mother and father. And he said, Amechi and my wife. Huh? I didn't know that he cherished our friendship to such a level that he considered me as one of the closest persons in his life. And I don't joke with that friendship too. So I think you fall into that same category. And I thank you very much. It's not been an easy background indeed. When people look at me and they wonder, and they think life is all about fun and enjoyment. First is that I attended a primary school, like every other person who attended public primary school. So I schooled at Sacred Heart Primary School in Akot by three. It's not a place for big men. It was a building that belonged to the Catholic Church that government also ran as a primary school. Halfway into that school, I was taken back to my village to complete at St. Teresa's Primary School in my village. When I finished, I got admission at Ibiromma. And then when my principal moved to GSS, Government Secondary School Club, in Yenegua, Bayelsa, he took me along. Few of us, he considered to be loyal and brilliant. He took me along to Okolobi, where I finally finished my secondary education. After that, I said, halfway, a few months after registering to study secretariat, I got an admission letter from JAMB that I've secured admission to study English. No, theater arts at the University of Portugal. My subject of study would have been law, but then I had to go to the University of Portugal to study theater arts. Professor Laro Timi was then he was both dean and head of department of theater arts. Then after 1 year, I changed formally to study English studies. So I graduated with a first degree in literature, English studies with literature emphasis. So the first degree in university, don't forget I was a student activist. After that, I joined politics. I joined politics in 1987. 88 when I came back from youth service. I was serving in 1988. I was partially served at Abuja and completed service at Port Harcourt. While serving in Port Harcourt, I met Chief Fosan Ajoh and Dr. Peter Odili in a meeting. And then they both adopted me. Chief Fosan Ajoh won the election in 1992 with Dr. Odili as deputy governor. So I worked as special assistant to Dr. Odili as deputy governor, and I worked as special assistant to the governor, Fosan Ajoh, on student matters. Then there was the stepping aside of Babangida and the emergence of where is this man? The man before Abacha.
Babangida.
No, after Babangida, the man before Abacha.
Oh, Shonekon.
The emergence of Shonekon. Then finally there was the Abacha take. I then joined, I continued with politics, became acting secretary of DPN at the National, admin secretary. I was local government secretary of NRC one time, then became acting secretary of DPN. And then at the end of the day, Abacha died. We briefly followed the road to APP, and then from APP we moved to the next party is PDP. We then moved to PDP. And then, as innocent as I was supporting a candidate for the office of, for the House of Assembly in my local government, in my constituency. When Dr. Odili called me and asked me to run for that seat, I called the gentleman, pleaded with him that I'd be directed by Dr. Odili to run for that seat, and he willingly agreed. I ran, I won. Big men then pushed me aside. I went to court, and I won the court because the court felt that I basically won the election, but you see the mutilation where they forged the result. And therefore, I was declared winner of that constituency. I was elected Speaker of the Liberty House of Assembly, and I was Speaker for 8 years. 8 years. I think I was the first Speaker in the country to have occupied that position for 8 years. After that, I had this agreement, and that led to my being chased out of the country. Dr. Odili arranged an aircraft that took me to Ghana. I stayed in Ghana. We were in court. I don't know whether it's right to say this, but they were totally paid by lawyer to be in court, and at the end of the day, we won the case. Today, the case is seen as a locus classicus, even though the National Assembly, it's important that everybody knows this, that it is not the Supreme Court that overruled that case. The National Assembly in a formal election. But then I became a governor for 8 years. History is there for everybody to see. The roads, the primary schools, the scholarship for people who went overseas, the health centers, the doctors we employ, the flyovers that we built all over the state, the power in Eleme on air, the power in Pai, the agricultural projects. What is farm?
Songhai Farm. Songhai Farm. We went there together.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. The banana farm that they have cut off and abandoned. Electricity to Ogoni, to all parts of the. We even got security under control. We bought 2 aircrafts. I heard it's been given to the Air Force. The responsibility of that aircraft, of the pilot of that aircraft, would have been to be flying all over River State, and they will be seen 20 kilometers away from any point. That way, you can't commit any crime and run away from River State. We will certainly get you. Unfortunately, I'm no longer the governor. Well, I was fortunately, because I've done my 8 years, I'm no longer the governor of River State. I don't know what's going on there. Then it's history that there was a confrontation between the governors led by me and the former was the first director general in the country to have led or been part of, not led, the first director general, because if I use the word lead, they will say, what about the others? But I was the first director general to be a director general to install an opposition government, which is led by the president, President Buhari. And he kindly Minister of State for Aviation. Now I'm still the Minister of Transport for another, I don't know how long to please the president, but at least by May this year, by September or so, I will have done 5 years in office as the Minister for Transport. And that would be a record breaking Minister of Transport. I don't think any minister has done 5 years the Minister of Transportation. And that's my history. How old am I? I'll be 55 in May. I graduated from university, I think at the age of 22. By the age of 34, I was a speaker. By the age of 42, I was a governor. By the age of 50, I became Minister for Transport, and I'm 55 now. That's my history.
Wow, what a journey. What a journey. Of all of these, it seems someone has called you. Your phone is going off. Hello? Hello? Can you? It seems someone has called. Hello.
Can you see me? Sorry, it was under call.
I knew it was a call. I knew immediately. So which of them has been your most tedious and challenging?
Well,
was it the legislator? Was it when you were the executive? Or was it now that you are minister?
Different assignments comes with different expectations and how do you put it? I enjoyed being a speaker. Why? My colleagues were literally nearly age mates, and we were young, we were traveling around. Yes, I had a young wife. I had children. My wife has been all because she took care of the children. A bit of freedom, but when he became governor, he became more responsible. At this point, you are leading nearly 6 million to 7 million persons. And you have to gauge, you have to say, what are their needs? And you have to really ask them. Most people have forgotten that not even the budget know what they wanted. And primary, at that time, to everybody in the state was security, and we dealt with security, immediately dealt with security. So each one presents his own challenges, and you focus on that. In Nigeria, the current challenge we have is that the economy needs to run. And for the economy to run, you need logistics, and logistics is essentially about transportation. So we are fortunate that the president is interested in infrastructure. Ministerial assignment. Like we are nearly almost approved the the Ibaka Seaport, the one in Akwa Ibom, Ibaka is possible.
The one in Akwa Ibom,
which is being done by the Akwa Ibom state governor. We have gotten presidential approval for the Bonny Deep Seaport. We have the Lekki Deep Seaport is under construction. The problem we have now is COVID. Why do I say COVID is the problem? You know, the president had approved that we do a Bonny Deep Seaport with an industrial park in Port Harcourt and a railway line from Bonny straight to Maiduguri, going to Yobe. Now, in fact, we are almost at the conclusion of the loan infrastructure, because the Bonny Railway cuts across Umahia, all the southeast to northeast. We are negotiating the loan with the negotiation of the loan for Ibadan to Kano, which includes Kano to Kaduna, Kaduna to Abuja, which we already have, Abuja to Mina to Ilorin, Ilorin to Ibadan. Then we are also negotiating the one from Bonny to Maiduguri with a branch line to Yobe, approved by the president. But believe me, nobody can say anything that will happen now with COVID-19 in place. We'll wait and see what happens to the global economy and see what the Chinese will say at the end of the day. If the Chinese is still going to give us the funds, then we'll construct all this. Anyway, thanks. That's the challenges we have met and how we responded to them.
Well, it's good that you've mentioned the Chinese, because I was going to ask about them at the end of the day. There seems to be a lot of people saying that that we are over relying on the Chinese, that they are our new colonial masters in Africa. How do they act?
What have they colonized? In fact, when I saw that some people were refusing to allow the Chinese medical team into Nigeria, I said, what is this? Let them give us a scientific reason, not propaganda, why they say the Chinese should not come in. First, there is no treatment for COVID-19, so you can't say they're here to treat anybody. But you need to test. You need to test. So what the best they have...
Why the Chinese? Why should it be the Chinese to test?
Is there any country that has offered you and you said no? Is there any country that has offered to you and you said no? Now, the Chinese offers you free of charge. And don't forget the responsibility of government is, I swear that I will save lives and property. You didn't say, I swear I will do roads, I will do water, I will do light. That's ancillary. That's something that comes that you just want to do, that you have to do for the country because you have responsibilities. But one thing that is an impeachable offense is when you don't keep to those constitutional provisions. And so the president has a responsibility.
Hey, another phone call. Wow.
I thought I put the sign that, so why did the call come through?
I knew it was another phone call. I said it.
But does it affect what's up? This that?
No, once you put do not disturb, it shouldn't interfere at all. Line. No, you can do it. You can actually do it.
Let's continue.
Push.
If we see another call again, I'll go back there. Okay, so
okay.
I think because you need to ensure that we are testing. And to ensure that we are testing, we have to have the equipment for testing. I don't see what is wrong if we receive those equipment. I don't know why anybody will criticize government for that. Believe me, I have no apologies to render because the government has a responsibility and they are discharging that responsibility.
African leaders love to do business with the Chinese.
I told you before that one thing I don't like to do. Luckily, I'm not the minister for foreign affairs, but I don't want to be accused of diplomatic stupidity. I don't want to get involved into diplomacy. Honestly, I don't want to. Like, I like the word you use, propaganda. I don't want to get involved. What I want to get involved in is, at the end of COVID-19, at a putter meter, I will get you by the. Now, let me tell you, if you go there on your own, the stations are ready. The first station is at Apapa. The Apapa station is named after Ahmed Tinubu. Am I right? Ahmed Bola Tinubu, Governor Ahmed
Bola Tinubu. Bola Ahmed.
The third station is at Agege, is named after Fashola. The fourth station is at is it Agodo? Yes, at Agodo. I don't know what's named up. Dayo, Ransom Kuti.
Ransom Kuti.
The seventh one is at Abeokuta, named after Professor Wole Soyinka. The eighth one is at Olodo. I don't know who we named it after. But the last one is at Ibadan, named after Chief Obafemi Awolowo. That's what I want to see. That's what the push should be proud of. And it's funded by the Chinese loan. Right? What's up? I hardly even go to social media. You know, I tell my wife that one reason why I will grow old is I don't really know those things right about me. I just carry on life.
I know. Okay, before we continue, if I don't know what you like, we were prepared for you, I told you.
The former Prime Minister of France told me that he likes Asha a lot.
Yeah.
I wake up, I see you, as you leave.
What I've done your day.
I see you, I see you, as you leave. When we kiss, I want thee. For you're far away, be better.
That's your bad part. Where is Asha now? Is she still in France? Is she still in France?
Is that what?
Is Asha still in France?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. But, you know, and so we're fully ready for you. Now,
well, I like music.
I know. Don't worry. We have more. We have more coming. We're not done with you yet. We have more coming. Now, I wanted to say, could you take us through the old gamut of what it takes to be the Minister of Transport? Because we're talking about trains and all that. So what other things do you do, the departments under your watch?
Well, you know, key to transportation is the fact that the economy needs to be propelled. And you need to have railways, the seaport needs to work and all that. So what are the agencies that are under me that we look after? There is the NIMASA that has to do with both safety, security, and the administration of the shipping activities. You had the National, just like the new appointee in NIMASA, Jamu, Jamu. Then you have MPA headed by Hadiza Bala Usman. And then you have National Inland Waterways Authority headed by George Moalo. You have Nigerian Institute the school at Oron. Basically, is the agency that deals with the waterway security, administration of shipping, and all that. And currently, a contract of about $195 million to $200 million to an Israeli firm can protect our waterways. In fact, the rate of kidnapping has made us to be number one in the world in terms of insecurity in our waterways. So we because so coming from Togo, not Bonnie. Now am I able to kidnap? Now in the last 3 months, some Russians were also kidnapped. A lot of people are being kidnapped regularly. So we have that responsibility, and the president is very conscious of that. Before this time, the one was Somalia. From Somalia, it moved to Gulf of Aden. Went to the Gulf of Aden. From Gulf of Aden, now Nigeria is number one. Then we are number three. So basically, we need to tackle that, and we're tackling that. There are out of the illegality in our waterways, they are fighting to finish, to stop the security contract. But unless the president removes me as Minister for Transport, I will ensure that that contract is completed and that our security men get to the water to stop this insecurity. Then, the time lag by which people wait for goods have improved at the seaport. So the new management or the management of MPA has gone a bit further. The administration of the seaport. It is more because of the bad roads. That's why we're working hard to ensure that we complete the railway line from Abuja seaport to Kano. Now there is a connection up to Kano. In the same manner, we are trying to, like we said, there are no seaports in Nigeria. What we have, we have river ports. So we have the river port in Apapa. We have the river port because the tea of the ocean. So we have the river port in Pinkan. We have the river port in Apapa. We have the river port in Port Harcourt. We have the river port at Oné. We have the river port at Warri, Calabar. We have about six river ports. So the first seaport will be that of Lekki. And you can take those very big ships that either go to the Republic to birth and discharge or discharge midstream. All that will stop when we CCCC. So they were to construct the Bonny Deep Seaport. Like I said, I can't say much on that because of COVID. Then the Akwa Ibom State government is constructing the seaport at I'm trying to remember the name now, but it's located in Akwa Ibom, which is being done by the governor. The governor is doing the part of the Akwa Ibom at Warri. Don't forget, we have completed the rail line from Warri to Itale. Completed. In fact, when I went for the burial of my CSO, I used the train from Abo to Itabe, then drove from Itabe to Abuja. Jonathan. That's why we want to name the Abo station after President Goodluck Jonathan. The station at Abo includes a big yard and all that, and a 1,000 housing estate for rail staff. All that will be named after President Goodluck Jonathan. Because he actually completed it, bought the locomotives and coaches and started the commercial activities, just like we finished in Lagos Ibadan. You know, there were criticism that we won't finish it. Put a meta to Papa, which is the second leg of the contract. What else have I forgotten? That's what I can remember now about the responsibility of the Minister for Transport. And I have a wonderful Minister of State for Transport. You know, most people don't look at her contribution. They look at her beauty. But having worked with her, I don't look at her beauty. I look at her contribution.
Mimi Sola. Exactly. Yes, yes. No, very smart. She's doing
quite a lot. She's a smart lady.
Very intelligent.
She's doing quite a lot in the sectors that she's handling.
Fantastic. Things I like about you is that you've acknowledged the role played by the former president, Goodluck Jonathan, because a lot of people.
Our government, you know, what I like about the president is that when we came, he said, nobody should abandon any project. Go back to your ministry, identify the projects at the stage of completion. Apply for money to complete it and move ahead. That's what we did.
Okay, maybe it's your guys on social media.
That's because.
And then
that's because the people from Goodluck's government also claimed that they started Lagos Ibadan. Lagos Ibadan was an entire forest opened up by the Buhari's government. Nobody.
But that Lagos Ibadan.
We should also not fail to the idea, but was started by Goodluck. But we've done quite a lot. The President Buhari's government completed Itabe to Warri was left abandoned for 34 years. And we didn't borrow one kobo to complete it. We did not borrow one kobo. The president insisted that money would be funded. I mean, the project would be funded from the budget. So he funded it 100% for the budget. Don't forget, from the Lagos Ibadan project, we got the Chinese to build a factory. They are building a factory now where we will be manufacturing locally the locomotives and coaches, and we'll create jobs. All that is attributable to President Buhari's government. Don't forget, we got the Chinese to agree to build the University of Transportation where we'll train our local engineers so that we can build our own trains by ourselves and build our own railway lines.
Wow. You are combining the job of information with transport.
No.
Because the way you are selling it is so sweet. It's like sugar and garri.
No, but they are realities. Do they exist? The answer is yes, they exist. You get the point?
Yes, I'm listening. I'm listening.
Do these things exist? The university, they were about to start construction before this COVID. The railway, the factory, they already started construction. The railway line between Ibadan to between Lagos to Ibadan is almost completed. We've completed from Ebute Metta to Ibadan. What is remaining is Ebute Metta to Apapa. Do they exist? To Alaja, heading towards Warri. Do they exist? The answer is yes. And like I told you, the only problem we have, what he says is that, Amechi, let's do our work. Let us be criticized. When we leave office, history will judge us.
Trust me, if they pummel your government so much, history may not judge you well.
History is not what you say. History is about facts. So if you say there was, if you say tomorrow, Dele, for instance, you say tomorrow there is no railway from Itabe to Warri. You see that I'm yes, you see
that yeah, online.
You will see that there's now a railway we completed. I didn't say we started it. We say it was abandoned for 34 years. And we've completed it. If you go to Ebute Metta and by God's grace at the end of COVID and people start using the railway. No, this is about facts. You can write as much as you want. What you will say is that to determine my own narrative. My own narrative is that I challenge the opposition. Anybody who talks, I say, let's go to the transportation for us to go to the site.
We will be reporting live from
the end of COVID-19. The first Dr. Chidamota, Dr. Gumbi, the former NUJ President Wahid, and all of them. All of us will take a ride. Plus some ladies who worked with me. We ought to go there for Ebute Metta and take a ride and see. So that we can, you know, I have a friend. His name is, but Amechi is one of our greatest critics. So one day, I picked Amechi, and I said, now, let's go. But then we've not even gotten to Ibadan. We've gotten to Ibadan, but we've not gotten to the final station. And I took them on a ride. The three of them wrote three differently, and they all considered to one thing, that we are working. In fact, let me tell you what Amechi did. Amechi called me by the side and whispered to me.
Go and write it. That you should go and write it. You shouldn't
and he did. And he did. He wrote about it. He wrote
that's
about
good.
It. Sam wrote about good. It too. And Eddie also did write about
it. All these your projects, are you sure that they are all viable commercially?
The railways are not viable commercially. They only prepare the economy. Take, for instance, there was a period that tomato, the price of tomato was very high in Lagos. The transport tomatoes from Kano to Lagos. And we did. Once he could transport tomatoes from Kano to Lagos, the price of tomatoes in Lagos crashed. That's about the economy. You get the point? Imagine the time it takes to move goods from Lagos to Kano. It takes 14 days to move a coach from Lagos Seaport to Abuja. 14 days. And you're in Lagos, you're in Kano. Eight to 9 hours. You're in Kano. No customs, no immigration, no police, nobody. Nobody. Take the rail line from Lagos to Ibadan. It's 156 kilometers. It's 156 kilometers from Lagos to Ibadan, and it's double track. So it's essentially 312 kilometers. Now, if you do 156 kilometers, you will need it for an expressway, 1 hour plus, less than 1 hour 30 minutes by express. All the stations, then it may take you about 2 hours to get to Ibadan. Now, so if you're a businessman who wants to do business in Ibadan, or if you live in Ibadan and want to come to work in Lagos, if you leave Lagos, you get to work. Now, it will bring down the cost of housing for those, the cost of feeding, and a lot of other economic.
There is a follow-up to that, that the loans that you've taken, are they not too plenty?
Again, what the president will tell me. The president will say to me, and Messi, if by the time we the reason why we are doing the Lagos to Kano River, that the Obasanjo government left $68 billion in our SS school account. $3 to $9 billion. And if we had $68 billion, the same way we should have done the Port Harcourt, the Lagos to Calabar, which has to do with the South-South, and the same way we have done the Port Harcourt to Maiduguri, which has to do with the Southeast and the Northeast. Now, we didn't do them.
Wow. I think it's the phone again. Please bear with us. Please bear with us. Bear with us. It will be back shortly. I think we lost him. Okay. I guess I don't know if I have to go off or. Very, very informative. I hope I still have a few more questions before we close at 8 o'clock. Ah, Baba Kenny Ogube, I'm seeing you. Wow. Wale Adeyemo, all the way from... Okay, you are in North Carolina, I believe, today. You are not in New York. Hey, Abby herself, Sterling Bank. I can see all our loyal followers here. Please, have you seen? I can see Mrs. Ogunbi online. My own sister, Wumi Ogunbi, once a beauty queen, always a beauty queen. Good to see you, ma. As our very dear Uncle Yemi. Wow. This is going so well and so smoothly, but I see all the way from Germany. I'm seeing you, Lizzie, Sister Lizzie. I can see you. So many people online, so many people. Wow. Has anyone seen him online? Okay, I have seen him. Fantastic. Glad we didn't lose him totally. So he should be back in a moment. He should be back.
I disabled my WhatsApp, so let me see whether that will save us.
That That's why you are the Minister of Transport. Yes, go on, please. From where you
What did I say last?
Yes,
taking these loans. There was one mysterious write-up in the social media when I said that the president said and we will not wait until we are chased away by those who criticize us. Now, he asked, is the president being reckless in taking loans? The answer is no. How much have we really taken? I can say, as for my ministry, it's not that big. I don't know about other ministries. But my ministry is the biggest in terms of the loans. So what have we taken? We took $500 million to come, not to me. The Goodluck Jonathan's government took $500 million. The remaining money, which was about $200 million, was paid by the federal government out of our budget. We didn't borrow that. So the Goodluck government borrowed $500 million. Which did we borrow? Not in aviation. I think there's some money borrowed, some little money borrowed in aviation when I was the minister, when they were under me. I don't know what it is now. Then, when it comes to railway, where they say we borrowed money. So I've counted $500 million borrowed by Goodluck government. We have borrowed $1.6 billion for Lagos to Ibadan. Finished. You know, when they say all this is, we've not gone beyond $2 billion. We are proposing to borrow $5 billion from Bonny to Maiduguri, passing through southeast and northeast, or the northeast. That again has not been given to us. So what we have actually borrowed is $2 billion in Ministry of Transport.
Wow.
But when the other right, they will say, oh, we have borrowed $20 billion, we borrowed $50 billion. And for me, I just want my peace. I don't go to social media. I don't go to WhatsApp is part of social media. So I don't go to that myself.
Well, and you will read. When they write things about you, we send it to you. We'll find you. We always find you.
But
and then
why do I have to respond to lies? No, tell me why I have to respond to lies. A man says we borrowed $8 billion. When I know that the only thing we have borrowed, is the $500 million that was borrowed under our government. And when you hear $1.6 billion, we actually paid 50% of the $1.6 billion. We paid. It's not going to come from anybody. So actually, if you look at it, what we may have borrowed would be about $1.4 billion because we have to pay 50% of the $1.6 billion. Then the extra funds to complete the project as we expanded also came from our budget. It's not from the loan. You get it?
Well,
so when people say they've been borrowing money, it's under $2 billion.
And you believe you have done so much with the money borrowed?
I think we have almost completed. Okay, then they lent us another $200 million. I think it's part of the $1.4 billion. Yes, it is. We've almost completed Lagos to Ibadan. So what else? We're waiting for COVID. If not for COVID, by now we'll be running Lagos to Ibadan.
Go to the last segment. I think our time is fast spent. We play yet another music for you. So let's go. Let's take you back home a bit. I hope the music is ready. I'm going to go to the hospital. We decided to
take you home. Someone is saying, "You should give them a chance to ask questions."
Well, we have another chance. This is just the beginning. We must say that we are taking good now from my office in Lagos. I can reach you in Abuja. So this is the new television in town, and we'll be bringing a lot of our leaders across Africa, not just Nigeria. With the former wife of the Prime Minister of Zimbabwe, Apostle Lokadia, is watching us live from South Africa. We have people from all over the world watching this program, and we thank them. So before we go, I want us to leave the realm of politics and go back to my love. If you look behind me, you will see my library. And I know you have one of the I'm very jealous of your library. I thought I had books until I entered your library. So could you tell us about your love for books?
Part of my library.
It should be nice. Yes.
You can see this.
You need to tilt the phone. Yes, I can see your books. I have seen. Oh, wow. Wow. It's such a massive room of books.
Let me take you to the. That's a section of my life. Let me take another section.
I can see books everywhere.
Can you see? What? I love reading books. I love reading books. And I'm currently studying a degree in law. And I'm reading. Wow. But I was reading when you called. I had to just move. Information, knowledge. I respect and adore men of letters. That's my friendship. That's why I have a friendship with you. And I don't joke with people who are readers. I give them their due respect. I don't want them insulted because it takes being brilliant is not a thing you pick on the road. It means you read.
It's not a joke.
It's not a joke.
No, I remember you took me to Professor Soyinka. It was quite an experience. Oh, Prof. I salute you wherever
a very kind man. He's a very kind man to me. And I
a very good host, I must say. A very good host. Yes. So on this note, we would call it a day.
Before you call it a day, okay. I like to say that I have great respect for Bonaboy and Duncan.
Thank
and
you.
I will fail to promote my second son, who has I have three children. My first son just graduated 3 days ago in medicine, so he's a medical doctor now.
Oh, wow.
And my second son, who graduated last year in psychology and international law, is trying to produce his first album as a certificate. You ain't doing no music. So when he graduated, he said, "Dad, here is your certificate. I don't want to work. To work for myself." So he's trying to produce his album. I said, I just told him that if he wants me to contribute, we must sign an agreement that indicates.
Okay, congratulations. Congratulations.
Thanks.
To you and to my very dear sister. It's been nice talking to you, and we give you the last song that I'm sure you love to dance to all the time. Can we get it?
Oh, let go of my class again.
Thank you.
Before we sign off, oh my God, I'm dancing so much here. I'm so proud of this great Nigerian, great African. Oh, wonderful. You see, what we need are performance. I tell people, governance is about performance. And we can see, we'll bring you back again, but we'll sign off with that music. That's all. All we need is to praise God. That's all. Okay, since you spoke about Burna Boy, let's give him one Burna Boy for the road. Let's give him one Burna Boy.
Let me money,